not going anywhere, at least until halfway through the year.
Yeah.
I have a feeling he's going to be a trade deadline dude.
I think we can get a pick if he does perform well. Like two first, or not even that, just the first.
No, I think you're going to get second round picks for Dennis Schroeder.
Yeah, Dennis value is not like that no more.
For me, I think Schroeder's definitely seconds. I think DFS is teetering on a low first and maybe multiple like seconds. CJ, there's no reason you should not get a first or something like that, like a combo of first and maybe a couple, like, because he's still young and he has a very controllable contract.
Let us know in the chat who's value, like what's y'all values for CJ and Dorian Finney and Dennis Schroeder. Comment that in the chat right now.
Please. Hey, Jello, is that, how do we say it? Is it Jellio? I agree. I think at one point when we had DF, we initially got him. This guy was his, like, you could have gotten a first or two, but I just don't like, I think Marks has just waited too long with that. And I think his value is far much lower, even though, like, what's he making? Isn't he have like the better contract out of all of them anyways? Wasn't his like the
Dorian?
Yeah. Like, let me,
yeah, he has a very cheap, I think it's like a, it's like kind of like McHale's.
Dorian.
It's kind of like McHale's. It's very cheap for his value.
Very, I don't cheap. Know. I think.
Oh yeah, he's on a 4-year 55. Yeah, dude, this guy's making like 13, 14 mil. Like, come on.
Very cheap, man.
Yeah.
Like, and you got that. See, yeah, this is the part that's head scratching to me. Like, this guy has an amazing contract. He would definitely be a great veteran dude on a team. If for his value and what he can do, I'm surprised. Unless Marks is working on a legit deal or something, or both of them or what, but he's definitely let this man's value go way too low.
Well, Shane, I'll say this. I don't think it's gone. I'll say this McHale deal, in my opinion, I think it kind of messed up the market a bit.
That's what I said
earlier.
Yeah.
Mikal Bridges went for 5 picks. And we can all come together and say there's more wings that are worth more than Mikal Bridges. So if he went for 5, there's no way teams are not saying, well, damn, Dorian might be worth 2 now. Or CJ, he might be worth 1 or 2.
Yeah.
So you have to, the market did get reset with Mikal Bridges.
You might have fucked up the market. It's like the Rudy Gobert shit. Remember the Rudy Gobert? Yeah, Rudy Gobert shit all over again.
That yesterday, I brought that up too, where it was like, that was one of my thoughts, was like, bro, I wonder the trade that they made for Mikal and everything, and all, like, it clear, everybody was like, whoa, there's the standard, right? Like, good luck. And then it's like, I wonder how much that affected conversations with other teams trying to either get into the draft, moving these guys. And quite honestly, I wonder if Marks, after doing that, is like, yo, you're going to give me what I want for these guys. And they're just like, yeah, no, you got lucky. That's not going to happen again. Like,
yeah. Somebody said, yeah, CJ,
especially if this draft is so. Yeah. I mean,
I would.
McHale went for 5. There's no way you can't get 2 out of CJ or 2 out of DFS.
2 out of DFS, I feel like, is stretching, but
somebody said DFS is 1 first and 1 second.
I could see a first and a couple seconds for sure. No, I mean, well, let me ask you this. If you're a team, who's more valuable to you, CJ or fucking DFS?
I'll tell you this thing, it doesn't matter because they're both wings. Like, Kevin Durant said the best. This is a wings.
Well, Chad, if you had a choice between wings, CJ and DFS on a team, and your team was already stacked and you needed a guy like this, a veteran, are you going CJ? Or because, like, CJ has the athleticism, but I also think he's going to get hurt more than DFS.
True.
I think DFS is going to give you more time on the floor than CJ will. But CJ's on the floor, he's far more athletic.
Yeah,
and he needs to be set up.
These undrafted are starting to roll in, bro.
But DFS is a sneaky dude too, man. He can. How many times did we see him make something happen or just be smart?
He's a good defender. Like when he tries, like he's a great defender, man.
And he has good basketball IQ. I definitely think his IQ is better than CJ.
DJ Burns got signed by the Cavs.
Yeah, I saw that, bro. That was crazy. DJ Burns.
I'm saying, he should have gone second round. I thought he was decent enough.
Yeah, it's that. Like that's a perfect example, right? DJ Burns carried his team, the NC State, to literally the Final Four of the NCAA tournament, and he didn't even get a look. He didn't even get a look in the NBA draft. I know his body's crazy. I know he has he's bigger, but he has skill as I think he's 6'9". He's big, but he didn't even get a look. And Bronny James is 55. Yeah, everybody's talking about Bronny James. That's a perfect example, bro. Perfect example.
Did you mention PJ Hall?
PJ Hall too. Yeah, PJ Hall too.
Yeah, he's to the Nuggets.
Some of these guys don't even get a look. Didn't even get drafted. But Bronny James, number 55, he changes everything. Nike ads, that's not, you know what I'm saying? That's not fair.
Oh yeah, it's completely manufactured. That's why I tweeted out manufactured history. Yeah. stop it, dude. If you already have fucking photos, press things, videos, commercials, come on, dude. The first fucking Nike commercial I see, the king's son is here, the prince, and it's oh, dude, I'm gonna fucking, fuck that, dude.
This is crazy.
I mean, listen, I'm happy for the kid. When it comes to the medical aspect, being close to your dad, I get that. I have a boy. Mm-hmm. I get that aspect of it. That's got to be, I don't care. Even if it is controlled, that still is very cool that you get to do that. But it's just so fucking lame. If you're going to do it, just be honest what you're doing. Don't try to make it out to be something that it's clearly not. That's the part that bothers me. It's if you're going to just outright control from beginning to end, just say, yo, wouldn't you do it? Yeah. don't hide. Don't try to make it a. That would be like me. Let me see. How could I draft my son into something?
Somebody said CJ's contract makes him untradeable. That's what I was talking about earlier in the stream. I was like, when we paid him that bag, I feel like it fucked. DFS's contract, Saints described it, it's perfect. It's tradable.
Amazing. There's no reason he shouldn't be gone already.
Yeah, Dorian's contract is.
There's
so
no
cheap.
Such thing as an untradeable contract.
We
literally seen Russell Westbrook get traded twice.
I wouldn't say CJ's an untradeable contract, but I have a feeling the parties are way off on what they think he's worth.
He's not worth 20 plus million. Oh, 25 million was he?
No, but
again?
I mean, as far
million?
As compensation, I think there. I think with him, there's going to be potentially that more than anything. But
he's not worth CJ to me is worth 17, 18 million a year. But I don't know. Everybody's cap is going up since the cap is going up. Everybody's getting overpaid.
Yeah, I mean, I could. Again, if you put CJ on the right team and he stays healthy, see, that's the other part of this whole equation. And we did touch on this yesterday a little bit, is the coaching and how they were developing even the normal players and the younger guys and what they had them running out there, the constant change in and out players, the coaching change with two different philosophies and attitudes, that's the part that bothers me, is it really made a lot of these players look like shit. And there were a few players that rose above it all season. And just every time, Cam was one of them. I think Watford was they just had a different attitude that no matter what was going on, they went out there and they busted their ass. And you could tell the difference, which is why somebody said yesterday, I can't remember where I read it or heard it, that when they went to the Clays, and they remember McCall and CJ and them shooting, and it was so quiet. And then by the end of the game, when it was Clowney, Cam, Clax, and it was the other group, and these dudes were making buckets, the crowd was going wild.
Yeah.
You know, and it was because you saw it, the crowd and the Barclays saw that. They could see who was busting their ass and really trying versus who was just kind of winging it.
Yeah, he gave up.
You had Dinwiddie out there pretty much pulling a Harden. And DFS thought he was getting traded all the way to the fucking trade deadline. Like, and now we know that McCall has been playing sneaky man the whole time. And then what do you think CJ, I'd be just real curious to to see what CJ's side of all this is.
I know. Didn't Jay say that last stream that he wanted to go?
Yeah, but I'm curious of like if he's like, yo, fuck you, Mikal. I thought we were the twins. No,
I'm being dead at like, because every interview you see Mikal, it's like, yeah, man, we're Brooklyn, man. We're gonna have to fight. We're gonna have to do all this just to just go across the street, leave your man's high and dry. This ain't your man's. That's crazy. Like you pushed all this twins bullshit, and then you just to leave him the chance you get, the first chance you get.
Yeah. All right, I'm probably going to end this, and then if any Nets news come back, we'll be back on Nets Kingdom YouTube.
All right, I got one more thing to share before we get out of here, and this is fucking hilarious, dude. Wait a minute. Oh, no, it's kind of a setup. So somebody sent a picture, like, right off the bat. It said Bronny versus Theonis in garbage time. Like, and they use it as like a WrestleMania.
The Bronny memes are gonna be glorious. They're gonna be glorious on the internet, bro.
Yeah, people are comparing. I don't think Bronny will be as bad as Theonis, but they're pretty much. Comparing the two.
The undrafteds are still rolling in, but yeah, y'all. So it was a good NBA draft, man. I appreciate all the people who came and locked in with us day one and day two. Great. It was an interesting draft, but 2025, trust me, it's gonna be a movie. 2025, it's gonna be a movie.
Ace Dylan, we got some company.
Cool.
Four picks in that draft, and most importantly, we hold our own.
Yeah.
Shout
out to everybody in the chat, Richard, Usable Fiverr. If you guys can go to Nets Kingdom and just hit the like button for us on YouTube. Everybody, our Twitter family will be back. What's the next time? We'll probably stream if there's something like crazy trades or crazy news.
Any three-team deal that involves Mikal. If this Mikal Bridges deal gets finalized and a third team is involved, or we maybe get it McBride.
Yeah.
Watch out for something.
I feel like as soon as I end this game, something's going to happen as soon as I end this game.
What's Cam Johnson DFS, that'll be huge.
Yeah. What's Dennis the deal Broder, with Ben McBride? Simmons? What's the deal with McBride? Like, is he a shooting guard, point guard? What is he, a combo guard?
Kind of. He's a like a Cam Thomas with much better defense.
Yeah.
How's his passing ability?
He's not really like a pass guy like that.
Nothing to really talk about.
He's a way better. He's a catch and shoot. He's a combo guard, but he plays defense like
I remember seeing him a little bit when we played the Knicks, but I really didn't pay attention to him. Yeah. Like I saw him a couple times, but
he's not like he doesn't score like Cam. Like Cam is a better like in open space. Cam can create off the dribble and shoot better. Like
I think this guy has a better. If I remember correctly, I think he would go to the basket better than maybe.
He does better than Cam is like he's a more efficient shooter. Like you throw it to him in the corner, he can. There are games where he'll have like six. He can have six threes in a row. Like he gets hot like that. Like,
but how's his game to the basket?
Going to the rim, he's not. He doesn't. He's not really like he. Cam is better. Cam is better than going to the rim.
Okay. Is he a good mid? Is he a good midy guy?
He can hit it, but it's not like Cam Thomas either. I think
so. He's mainly just all over the place, kind of shooting, taking his shots.
Think of like a defensive monster, but then like he can catch and shoot, and he can pull up and shoot sometimes. That's what I think. Okay. Let me know in the chat if you describe McBride to you in the chat real quick before we get out of here. Somebody said Nets Kingdom 2025 draft stream about to do numbers. Yeah.
Oh, hell yes. You know that's a fact.
If we get the number one pick, we about to have like 3,000 people in here.
Oh, watch. Dude, if we get the number one pick, it's going to go nuts. But if we get like – if we get any other pick other than the first – no, I think if we're in the top three, it'll be bumming that we didn't get it. But knowing we stay in the top three, I'll be extremely happy. But if we get like fucked and get like the seventh pick or something, oh, yeah. We might not even stream that day.
Well, yeah. So – if there's a lesson to take from anything, it's to look at everything and realize that we need to go into everything with the worst in mind. We have to just expect the worst. You got to expect the unexpected. You got to prepare to be disappointed with everything. We thought we were going into this draft after we got blown away from the Mikal Bridges deal and what we did with the Rockets.
Yeah.
But we didn't make any moves with Cam Johnson and DFS like we thought we would.
Wait a minute. Dark Thing's saying there's 876 people watching. What the hell? Is that a combination between YouTube and
Twitter? I told you the Twitter numbers go crazy. It's Twitter numbers.
Yeah, but how do you capitalize on that, though, bro?
That's Twitter numbers.
I wonder if this is giving me engagement and impressions.
Did you see yesterday? Yesterday we had like 13. It was like 1,500 people on here. I was like, what the? It was crazy.
Let me check out the monitor. Hey, maybe I need to check out the.
G-Wiz says, what if he messed around and make the playoffs? We will not.
Who? The Nets? No way.
Come on. Bro, come on.
Anybody that helps us even win 5 games next year, we got to get them out the
city. That's what I said. We got to get rid of
CJ.
Get rid of Dennis. Get rid of Ben. Get rid of Dorian.
How about this? If you start having better games than Cam Thomas, you're getting traded.
Yeah.
Get rid of all those guys. All those guys can help us get wins. Get rid of them. That's what Sean has.
Listen. I don't think people should be upset about us not participating in this draft, because I honestly think for us to get in this draft, it would have cost us and given up shit we didn't want to do. But I have a feeling that, like, this is like, we're still more trades are coming. There's no way you trade Mikal and then just stop. I'm sorry. Like, something's coming. Hopefully, it is. I'm just hoping that these trades are, I'm not expecting any kind of a magical returns. Just don't get taken. That's all I care about. You may not get exactly what you want, but just don't get fleeced in the deal. Like, that's all I ask. You can't afford anymore to just like let shit slide. Like, you either make the deal or you don't.
Yeah.
It's either good for you or it's not.
Shout out to D Grant. Okay, we got a Knicks fan. Knicks fan said, I'm a Knicks fan. I think Deuce and Cam have their strengths and weaknesses, but overall, if Deuce gets better in his drives to the hoop, Deuce will have the upside. See, that's what I was saying. I was saying Deuce and Cam separate from me is the 3-point shooting, because Deuce has some next level 3-point shooting. Like,
so then my next question about Deuce, then, like, Grant, since you've probably, I don't know, you may have watched Cam Thomas more than I've watched McBride. Can these two guys play together from what you know, like what you've watched? Like, how do you think get a vibe that these two could play together? Or are there?
No.
That's
kind of new class.
They're too short. That's too short.
You said it's too short?
way too short.
Deuce can play off the ball, though. That's the thing. Deuce can play. He don't need the ball to score. Like, you can just throw it to him and he can, like.
Deuce can be a catch and shoot guy, but I think their height comes into question defensively.
Yeah, they're two shorties.
Think about the Jalen Brunson. Jalen Brunson has the ball 90% of the time, but Deuce still be scoring.
Yes, Daniel, we want them gone. And I don't want them gone because I don't like them. I want them gone because we're tanking and we're starting over. And there's no reason.
We want everybody gone. Yes.
There's no reason for these guys to be here anymore. After you traded Mikal, it's a wrap, dude.
Yeah. I want Scam Johnson off my team, man. I want Cam Johnson gone. I want Dorian gone. I want Dennis Schroeder gone. Well, Dennis, we might be able. Well, he'll be the one vet, maybe.
Ben Simmons gone. Let him just trade him off.
If anything, let him play up his value and trade him at the deadline.
Just everybody.
I do think that's going to happen to Ben Simmons, and I do think that's going to happen to Schroeder.
DFS for sure.
But if you start the season with CJ and DFS, like. The thing I'm looking to avoid again is starting the season with players that don't want to be here.
Mm. Yeah.
And I'm pretty god darn sure that DFS and CJ probably want to go to another team.
They don't want to be here. We know why would they want to be here? They definitely don't want to be here, bro.
And it could be as simple as just like, you just traded the future, and I'm not looking for a rebuild right now. So
Daniel M say, if I offered you THJ, Green, Maxey, and a first for Cam Johnson, would you guys take it? Yes.
Green. That's wait.
No. Yeah, that's Dallas. No. So
THJ, Green, Maxey. No. I would take. I feel like there's too many salaries though.
I don't want Taylor. Is that Taylor Horton? No,
that's Tim Hardaway Jr.
Tim Hardaway Jr. No, no.
How do any of these guys make sense for a rebuild unless we just want to dump them?
They don't.
If you want CJ, give us a draft pick and young guys with cheap.
You better be including Jaden Hardy.
Yeah, give us young guys with cheap contracts. Young guys with cheap contracts.
I'm saying
we'll take an expiring. I'll take an expiring too. If you give me a good expiring, I'll take an expiring.
That's the other thing. Now that they've pulled the trigger, and this is again why maybe part of these trades have not hit where they are yet, is it's like the Nets are not looking to take back similar guys or similar contracts. Like I realize they're gonna have to take something back.
Yeah.
But it can't be. Nah, that's too much. I mean, I don't know. What are those guys' contracts?
THJ, I think all those guys have like another year on their deals.
I think more Maxey so got Maxey another year. And THJ are meant to match the salary, but I think the main prize of that is getting Green.
Yeah, I'll take Josh Green. I'll take Green, but THJ, I don't want THJ or Maxey. D Grant said to me they're the same player. Do spend a lot of time in G League. Of course, Tibbs likes him because of his defense, but his offense has improved. He can shoot from deep as well. Yeah, McBride is good.
I saw of him, he was like, yo. But I don't think he's long.
His offense is not as good as Cam Thomas's, though, bro. It's not. Like Cam,
McBride is good, but the problem with this, pairing him with Cam Thomas, granted, both Thomas and Brunson are short guards. Yeah. Thomas is not the playmaker we've seen Brunson be. Like, you know what I'm saying? We haven't really seen Cam Thomas even play make one fifth of what Brunson has done so far.
I will say the biggest Chubbs.
Yeah, I guess I gotta see it, but I don't think the fit is gonna be like what we say, where it's like, oh, if he can do it with Brunson, he can do it with Thomas. Like, nah.
Yeah.
And I'm also not ready to just give Cam Thomas like he's the point guard like some fans want. Like I need more time with that. And maybe this season you see more of that happen, but I don't want to just automatically say, can't let Cam Thomas completely run it. Like, nah, like I still think we desperately need a point guard that knows how to run the show. Like,
Cam Thomas can score, but it's very concerning that most of the time when you score 40, you have a negative record. That's concerning.
Yeah. Jaden Hardy, Daniel M. I would take Jaden Hardy. Maxey has 2 years. Yeah, all these guys have 2 years on their deals, though. No, Green has 2 years too. I feel like all these guys. Yeah, don't give me no guys with 2 years. Give me expirings. Expirings and young guys.
Listen though, if it's a young guy and there is 2 years, but the contract is like super low, like I can understand maybe taking one of those guys or two of them. But
I would take one of those guys.
But because I think that is going to happen to some degree. I wonder if they're just like looking for the youngest guys they can get, even if they have like a couple years on their. It's going to be.
Are we going to be like Tim Hardaway Jr., Jaden Hardy, and like. Let's say a first too. I mean, I wouldn't hate that because you got to think if you're just dumping Cam Johnson, you're able to get Jaden Hardy who has upside, and then you're able to get a guy you can dump and have more money for the offseason. That's even more money. Like, we'd be swimming in cap space if we were to just dump some of these guys, dude.
Yeah.
Like, if we were able to trade Cam Johnson for like an expiring and a young player on top of a first round pick, I feel like that's all we could really ask for, given it's just Cam Johnson. Like, he is a wing. But like for us, that makes all the sense in the world, I feel like. I feel like that makes sense.
To close out the stream, AJ, somebody tweeted, it has been discovered that LeBron James is sleeping with the newest teammate's mom.
Yo, who's coming up with these reports, yo?
That's fucking hilarious, but that's so smart, dude. That's hilarious.
Who's coming up with these?
Some dude named
Stephen. Get the Filipowski news and then this. No, the funniest thing from the draft was the zesty TikToks from McCade. I've been seeing those all over Twitter. Like,
bro, it's killing me. I haven't seen this man have one highlight where he's bouncing a basketball. It's just him dancing.
Somebody else said Bronny's inheriting beefs. You're all weirdos, man.
I inherit the all the McCain memes are bad for you, yo. It's like Joel Embiid is like, yo, get back on defense. And you just see like TikToks of Jared McCain dancing. And it's nasty, zesty ones too. It's nasty. Somebody said on the Nets getting McBride, we don't know yet. Reason why I'm asking about Cam Johnson and DFS is because the Mavericks might not be all in on Jeremy Grant and Matisse Thybulle from the Blazers. Ooh.
That was a thing.
The Mavericks might not be all in. Yeah, I think they should. We spoke about this, and we have another channel called Hoops Bro that we talk about this. But we were talking about what the Mavs need, and they need somebody, a third option. Like, I was saying Nico needs to keep his top six, starting five, and maybe his top six, and everybody else he should trade for something else. Like that Dwight Powell, all those guys. Get rid of those guys.
I don't think
Tim Hardaway, Kleber. Trade them for something else. Yeah.
Get rid of those guys, but I don't think they necessarily need a third. More so, Luka just needed to be better. Kyrie needs to be better. And the wings, for the love of God, have a decent series. Like, shoot decent from the floor. Yeah. That's really where it kind of messed up for the Mavs. Their wings couldn't shoot. Like, the Celtics effectively took them out the game multiple times.
Yeah. They need one more wing defender, and they need a guy that can score off the bench. That's why I was saying get Lonnie Walker, Mavs. If you're a Mavs fan, call Nico and tell him to get Lonnie Walker. He's a free agent. Lonnie can give you 15 off the bench. If Kyrie and Luka are off, Lonnie will get you buckets, bro. That's what he do. You saw him save Braun and AD in that one playoff. Remember that one playoff series where he dropped like 17 in the fourth? Lonnie gonna get them buckets, man. I'm telling you. Get Lonnie and get a wing defender, and then I think y'all are good. I think y'all are good. Keep everybody else and Derek Lively, all them boys. So we'll see what they do. Oh, see, Rexy's here. See, every time I'm about to go off, we get more people on Twitter. Like, now we're at 900. Every time I'm about to leave, it's like 100 more people show up. T-Rex says, sup everyone. I just woke up because the draft has been boring for two. T-Rexy, you didn't like the first round? The first round was kind of interesting. T-Rexy, you think we're gonna get McBride, T-Rexy?
Let me know.
Nah.
What? I see the memes now.
Hey, did you see the two I just said in the chat?
The Brody memes.
Bronny doing a TikTok, and then
if Bronny has a bad game, they're definitely playing this.
And then look, and then go to the next show, the next one. When Bronny pisses off his dad, show the next one.
Oh, hold on.
After the game.
Bronny has so many TikToks, they're gonna go crazy on that. Hater Report is gonna go crazy.
That's LeBron after the game when Bronny doesn't score 10. It's ridiculous, dude.
That's LeBron if Bronny has a bad game.
See, this is when I like Twitter. This is when Twitter's fun. Like, some of the shit that people are coming up with is just pure comedy.
Yeah. He said Lonnie Walker isn't bad, but he's not a third option. That's fair. But he's at least he's a cheap guy you can get that could score. I mean, Lonnie could be your decision if you strike out on Jeremy Grant. But Jeremy Grant's expensive, bro. He is.
See, that's the thing. We just don't need to be thinking of players like that right now at all.
Yeah. Johnny, he's expensive. But he would be – if the Mavs get Jeremy Grant, that would be great. That would be great for them. That would be great for them. T-Rexy said, I want him. Tank for Cooper. Yeah. That's what we plan to do. T-Rexy, call Sean and tell him to get rid of CJ and all them boys, bro. We need to tank.
Nah, someone said the ride home in the car after Bronny goes 3 of 14 the first time going to be wicked. That's hilarious.
That's funny.
That's hilarious. Yeah. Now, the Bronny memes are going to go crazy. The Bronny memes are going to go crazy. Yeah, y'all.
I mean, but dude, you already know everything is already pre-hyped up and ready to go now. Like, that's the part that's kind of hilarious, is it's like they've already got ads, videos, like
Yeah. Somebody said McBride might be a two-way player as a role player, but Cam Thomas can be a star in his role as a scorer with upside as a playmaker. That's fair.
We're having the McBride Cam Thomas battle in the chat today, huh? Y'all are battling for the league is turning into a two-way player league. That's a fact. I saw that too. I was gonna post that clip. Paul George went on his podcast and he was saying that. He was saying, like, he said the league is turning into positionless and it's gonna be two-way league. Like, it's gonna be where teams are gonna look for guys that could score and play defense. Like, everybody's gonna be two-way. Kind of like how Boston is right now.
Everybody's good, because model, that means that we're gonna get back to fucking good basketball.
Yeah.
Because like that, yeah. That is the one is okay. So the only advantage I have over you guys is watching a lot of basketball.
Yeah.
And there was a time, yeah, dudes were getting cooked, but by far you saw better defense and offense. Games were so much more. I'm sorry, like the playoffs that I remember growing up were some of the most exciting things I've ever seen. And in the last decade, I've enjoyed less and less. Some like every once in a while you'll get the good series, but by and large, most of the series are like you get 2-3 blowouts, maybe one or two good games, but somebody always, you know what I mean? And it's like,
yeah,
I don't know. I feel like game sevens have gone down.
No, I agree with you.
You know what I mean?
It's so it's not as exciting as it used to be.
No, and if the league is going back to that where these teams are like, nah, dude, you need to be able to do both and good.
Yeah.
Because that means games are going to get so much better.
They were making like rule change recently. They were having